Inside Job dropped on Netflix, so it's time to break it all down for you. My name is Deep Cut, welcome back to Cartoon Universe, and hit that subscribe button before it hits you. The show follows Reagan, an overachieving scientist working at Cognito Inc., a secret organization that is part of a broader group of organizations that control the world, all inspired by real-life conspiracy theory. She has recently taken over her father's job as one of the top scientists in the community, and he had something of a breakdown and decided that what they were doing to run and control the world was too much. Despite leaving Cognito Inc., he has a special deal with them to not expose their secrets in particular ways, and in return, he still gets some great benefits, like free lab-grown livers. Understanding the truth of how the world works at Cognito Inc. causes a lot of people to have breakdowns under the pressure, and many of them are a lot less amicable than with Reagan's father. The series opens with Reagan starting a new position at the company, where she works with a board of highly specialized individuals to push towards the New World Order. While Reagan does acknowledge the moral issues of working for Cognito Inc., she rationalizes that humans ultimately do need organization, and that is what Cognito Inc. provides in some ways, even if it turns out that they're actually purposely making climate change worse so that lizard people who live among the humans can stay at a comfortable temperature for them. The dark implication of this is that the entire world is just being terraformed for these lizard people who will survive in the overheated world as the real humans die off. And this is just one of the many conspiracy theories played for jokes within the show, with a lot of clever changes made to them for extra layers of irony. Immediately after starting her job, Reagan discovers that the others she works with don't like her personality, and they end up abducting a handsome-faced stranger and make him Reagan's partner at the business so they have someone endearing to talk to while Reagan does all of her cool science stuff. While Reagan does not like this at first, she eventually comes around to Brett, and they end up working together throughout the series, as well as with their strange board members, which includes Gigi, who is something of their public relations expert, Dr. Andre, who is important for their medical needs, particularly when it comes to drugs and the like, General Dolphman, a human surgically enhanced to be like a dolphin who handles their military needs, and finally Mike, a sentient mushroom from inside the Earth, which is confirmed to be hollow within the show as a opposed to flat. They spend an entire episode on the extra layer of absurdity that comes with flat earth theory, and even reveals that in the Inside Job universe, the whole flat earth thing was a joke orchestrated by Reagan's dad to trick people on the internet. Mike is a particular favorite of mine because of the crazy lore he has surrounding him, as opposed to the other characters, who all seem to just be generic elite humans for the time being. In the opening credits for the show, we can see Mike, or another creature like him, is coming up to the surface of the Earth and allowing apes to eat part of him. Mike has the power to connect to other living beings and can read the emotions of humans in the same room as him. Because of this, it would appear that apes may have been given their intelligence by Mike or another member of his species, which may explain why he has a hand in controlling what happens to the world, tying into real-life conspiracy theories about the origins of human intelligence. For those of you who have seen the series Ancient Aliens, there is essentially an entire school of thought that uses that same logic, but says that the visitors came from underground to influence humanity and our religions instead of outer space. Each episode focuses on a different conspiracy-related shenanigan, from trying to replace the president with a robot to going to the entrance to the Hollow Earth. Sometimes they even cross paths with other shadowy organizations, such as the Illuminati. These shadowy organizations all seem to be working their own agendas on behalf of several powerful entities or groups, slowly harnessing the powers of humans to achieve various goals. At the very top of this pyramid, at least within Cognito Inc., are a team of cloaked figures in masks who dole out all the orders. What their ultimate goals are remains to be unseen, but a large part of the series is premised on how this company is doing horrible things, and even with Reagan doing her best to make it as not evil as possible, she is only able to reduce their evil actions to 51% of their total actions. Actions that people like Reagan's father believe may lead humanity to a dark ending. While this season does not address where this is going, the strong focus on Inner Earth makes me think that it will play a big role. We are constantly getting references about it, and not just from Mike. We know there are mole people down there, and it was only thanks to a special seal made between the surface world and the Inner Earth that giant sea monsters like Krakens are no longer a threat to humanity, though they can be let out. Netflix has been really hyping this show up, and cartoon fanatics are very curious about it, as it is the first major work from Alex Hirsch since the greatness of Gravity Falls, and the world has been waiting to see how he will dazzle us next. However, it should be noted that while he is an executive producer on this show, he is not the creator of it. That title belongs to Shion Takeuchi. While the show is enjoyable and finds its fun balance extremely early on, it doesn't escalate very well as the series progresses, and can feel like one note for a lot of the series. The show reaches an emotional high point a little over halfway through, when Reagan is confronted with the possibility that her father may not be her biological dad, and that a famous astronaut may be her real father. Spoiler alert, but this turned out to be wrong, and Reagan realized who she is, for better or for worse, is because of her biological dad. Not because of his genes, but because of how he raised her. The series goes on to have a two-part finale, but I personally found it a bit underwhelming, though it was still fun. The show is funny from the get-go and doesn't have to do anything extraordinary to earn your approval. It knows its content well, creating clever inversions of existing conspiracy theories and finding fun ways to tie them all together. Anyone who has their walls up will quickly see them coming down, but that doesn't mean this will be your favorite show. When it comes to adult animation, each generation tends to be defined by one extremely popular show that the others tend to mimic in style and tone to some degree. Back in the early 90s, this was The Simpsons, which later became Family Guy, which later became South Park, and eventually now revolves around Rick and Morty. A lot of the adult cartoons coming out these days are just ironic sci-fi adventures, and Inside Job definitely feels like a byproduct of this system, and not just because of the animation style. The show revolves largely around the relationship of Reagan with her father, who read very much like softer versions of Rick and his daughter Beth, a similarity that is particularly striking after we've seen the more sci-fi capable Space Beth clone explore her own little side stories within the show Rick and Morty. That being said, it has been pleasant to see this dynamic through the eyes of a Beth-like figure, instead of just Beth's reactions through Rick's eyes, so in that way, when the show does dig into the relationship of Reagan and her father, it feels like we're seeing something a bit new. For those curious, the episodes all dropped on Netflix on October 22nd, and are all well worth the watch in my opinion. The show can be very crude, but it doesn't get into the more offensive side of conspiracy theories that you get into when taking them too seriously, so shouldn't present anything too stressful for viewers. For me personally, I'm excited to see how things change in Season 2. Season 1 was fun, but spoiler alert for the ending of Season 1, Reagan did not end up getting her big promotion, and instead, her father was welcomed back to Cognito Inc. after a pretty impressive fight between him and Reagan, so Season 2 will surely shake the dynamic up quite a bit, and it will be fun to see him in a position of power over Reagan instead of being a glorified extra who sleeps on her couch and just waits for shenanigans to ensue. But what about you guys? Do you accept your new shadowy overlords, or do you intend to fight back against the New World Order? Let me know in the comments down below, and click subscribe to join the resistance. See you guys next time.